our stage here. Great you're here with me. Let's take a seat and share some secrets of how you unleash the full potential of a digital twin. I'm looking forward actually to this topical conversation. Jochen, it's outstanding what you have realized in the electronic works in Hamburg. How did the collaboration with Daniel start? I mean, we're all for Siemens, but Siemens is huge. I mean, I have to say that. Actually, we use Hannover Messe to kind of meet new colleagues whom we maybe have talked to because it's potential interesting suppliers for the one or the other team. So in that case, how did your collaboration start?
Yeah, within Siemens, we have a unique situation. So we are currently using the products we sell to our customers in our own factories. And this is why we often act as a customer zero, let's say, for new product developments.
And you're the guinea pig?
Kind of.
You're the test station for what we are producing, but we also say we drink our own champagne because we're so confident and satisfied with what we produce that we are using these products as well.
You're right. And we have a very huge production network, and this is where Daniel pitched his solution idea, and we saw value in it, and this is how it started.
And you're responsible for?
Yeah, PCB production in Hamburg. So our plant in Hamburg produces semantic products for Europe and Americas. And we are producing PLCs, HMIs and stuff like that.
And it's quite an impressive number of pieces you produce there.
Yeah, we are producing about 16 million products per year.
16 million products per year. Now imagine.
That trend upwards.
Wow, really, really cool. So what is the crucial aspect that they all have in common? Daniel, now you come into play.
Yeah, so for us as a customer service, we work a lot with internal and external customers. And the interesting thing was when we were talking with them, they all told us about the same challenges and they had. So they said, hey, Daniel, we want to do simulation. We want to use simulation on a daily basis, but we don't have the people do that. We are factories. We cannot do the simulation stuff every single day without having those people. So what can you do about it? And this is when we decided, okay, we have to do something completely new and develop a new solution.
Mm-hmm. So new solution. You did not have a recipe. What was the first step?
Well, the first step, you mentioned it at the beginning, that we drink our own champagne. So usually when we come up with a new idea, with a completely new concept, we look for a first internal lead customer, what we call it, where we do a POC, where we have a look at the technology, how all the different things interact with each other. And when we know that the technology is proven, then we roll it out. So we scale it to other factories within Siemens, but also with first external lead customers, because for those external customers, the architecture is, again, a bit different, and we have to adapt step by step by step.
Mm-hmm. So what was the situation like at the electronics work in Hamburg?
Yeah, as I mentioned before, we are producing a lot of products per year, and we continuously have to improve. And this is why we switched almost 3 years ago from a value stream orientation in PCB production to a technology orientation. To be able to increase our output with the same amount of floor space and the same number of people. And along with this technology orientation, the complexity to control the PCB production increased. And yeah, to cover this challenge, we were looking for a sufficient solution, in this case, the digital twin assistant.
Mm-hmm. And the challenges you mentioned, they're referring to our consulting, implementation and optimization process. Daniel, can you explain what exactly these three buzzwords, these three steps mean?
Yeah, sure. So no matter if it's an internal or an external customer, we act according to what we call the consulting, implementation and exactly optimization approach. Which means in the consulting phase, we want to find out, first of all, what's the vision, what's the challenge, which technology we need. And then from this vision and from the overall perspective, we try to get down into single feasible steps to make this vision become a reality. And break it down into single feasible projects. And this is then when the implementation phase starts. So we make the vision come true with the small steps, with small projects. And once everything has been implemented and we know the technology works, then we also go into operation where we constantly optimize our customer's operation and, of course, our solution that we've previously implemented.
Mm-hmm. And how exactly did you implement this solution in Hamburg?
So, first of all, we decided to start a POC together. So we installed the MVP. And from a tech
MVP, maybe for those who don't
minimum
know
minimum viable
it.
Product. So we first wanted to realize really from a technical perspective, so all the elements of the solution in Hamburg. So the we built the model, a simulation model in plant simulation. We had this model in the cloud. We have the optimization algorithm in the cloud. We realized the connectivity and yeah, we have all these elements integrated and then started together this journey.
Okay, then you got all your tool set. You knew how you want to kind of go on this journey. What was the outcome?
Yeah, so from a technical perspective, really we were able to implement the complete breakthrough. So really what I said, all the elements were installed. From a user perspective, let's say, the solution delivers what it promises. So we wanted to generate a solution that is accessible for the worker at the shop floor, that he is able to start the simulation, to run the optimization run, and then to have order flow he can produce very efficiently in this machine pool.
Mm-hmm. All right. And user perspective, you mentioned what was the output. I think it was like really kind of going up instead of the numbers you had before.
Yeah. Due to this optimization in the cloud we realized together, we were able to produce 15% more products
wow.
on this machine pool. And we also reduced the number of setups by 50%.
Just by kind of changing very few little things.
You're right.
Very, very impressive.
Sounds almost too easy.
Yeah, this is kind of what I'm wondering about. How come that we did not find out about these little steps you just need to change and then it's ideal? Is there some secret behind that you look into these topics that you can easily change things that you maybe look into? You're working in this digital twin scenario for long, so you kind of know, like a doctor looking at some patient and saying, okay, could be this or that.
Well, the thing is, the crucial part during the consulting phase is we talk about business challenges. We talk about what are the challenges they want to solve, and then we have use cases, and depending on the use case and what we'd like to achieve from a business perspective, then we decide which technology to use. So in that case, it was the digital twin connected to the shop floor, but it could be any technology out there, and it's not like. Yeah, in the end, it's like a doctor having a look at his patient
yeah.
and then identifying what's the right medicine. Yeah,
that's what I meant. Now, the doctor kind of diagnosed. He got a good solution. The patient is feeling super fit. Looking into the future, what else will be possible with this solution, Jochen?
Yeah, we already planned another pilot in our factory in Karlsruhe.
Mm-hmm.
We decided for Karlsruhe because they are or they have already a matrix production, so their SMT production is connected to their test pool via AGVs, and to optimize also this production flow empowered by the digital twin, we decided for a pilot in Karlsruhe as a next step. And after the successful implementation, we are really planning to roll this out in a broader way. Yeah.
Wow. Sounds good. And Daniel, you're supporting again.
Yeah, sure. And for us, this was the first POC. We rolled it out. Now we go into the scale phase. But there are two paths that we will walk in the future. Well, of course, we at Siemens, we have a lot of electronics productions. But I think you can imagine that the potential is really high for other industries like the automotive sector, F&B, logistics, all of them. So this would be the first thing that we will will do in the future, scale it over other industries. And the other thing is, for Amberg, it was the scheduling of an X-ray area and to improve the machine allocation and things like that. But there are many more possibilities, like forecasting, having a weather forecast for your production, or doing scenario analysis, or something like a predictive control. So I would say the opportunities are
endless,
not unlimited, but there are various opportunities.
Okay, so your ideal day when you go to work, are you looking forward to kind of get a new challenge, or you want to rather go with your digital twin, your best companion, into like things you already know?
Well, it depends on the challenge.
Well, I'm sure Jochen got a few on the table working in a big plant like that.
That's absolutely true. Yeah, the actual situation is really challenging for us. Yeah, so the daily business is really hard at the moment, but also then introducing new technology to improve. Yeah, don't forget to continuously improve. This is also very, very necessary. Yeah, to be upfront. We are a digital lighthouse, so this is also something. You are challenged day by day, so you get a lot of visitors. They want to see new solutions. So on the one hand side, you have the daily problems, material supply and so on and so on.
Yeah.
And on the other hand, of course, introducing new technologies, supporting the development guys with their new solutions. And yeah, it's challenging, but it makes a lot of fun.
Maybe you can say some more about the Digital Lighthouse, because it was an award by the World Economic Forum, which is a really great award and a good reputation. Can you have a few sentences on that so that our audience learns more about which really great prize we got awarded with?
Yeah, we were announced really as a Digital Lighthouse by the World Economic Forum last year already. That was we had a very heavy assessment by the guys from McKinsey and by the World Economic Forum, and there we had different steps, and in the Corona crisis was really hard because it was virtual, and then we had to use cameras and to demonstrate really how the operators are using the technology, and that's not a slideshow or something like that. You had really had to prove what is already existing, and then we get announced in last year. And I think 5 days ago, Cedric Knighty received the physical award.
I saw the picture. This is why I'm asking. Yeah, it was all over social media. We finally got the award, and we are super proud of that. So congratulations for that and making this possible. And having the best partner, the wingman, so to say, to find the ideal optimization steps. This is of essence for sure. So you're here at the stage right now with me, but where can we find you and talk to you at our booth?
So I'm at the Resilience and Flexibility booth, and would be really happy if you could stop by and we have a conversation about digital twin connectivity and all topics related. So I would be very happy to meet you there.
Well, Daniel, and he's definitely the man who can solve your problems, because he analyzes them and then he finds the right solution. That's pretty cool. And let's just see it where you guys are at the booth, where the location is. Okay, right at the other side of our wonderful, impressive, nearly 3,000 square meter largest booth at Hannover Messe. This is where we find you, Daniel, and Jochen, you'll be around.
Yes.
Great. So your impression so far from Hannover Messe? We are back to life. We're right here at the crowded booth. How is it for you?
Yeah, it makes really fun. Yeah, we already had a lot of conversation about the solution at the booth.
Great.
We also had the possibility already to walk a little bit around, also to talk to colleagues, but other booths as well. So yeah, it makes fun. Yeah.
Cool. And Daniel, you already got a list of problems to be solved?
No. I'm really happy that we are back now, where we have in-person conversations with our customers. Very good conversations, and of course I learn a lot about how our solutions, how they are applied, what the challenges are, and what we will have to cover in the future. So I'm really, really impressed and happy to be here again.
So these are the best friends of our digital twin, and you know how to kind of tame it and use it, and further. All the best of luck for you. Have good talks here at Hannover Messe, and a big hand of applause to the two of you. Great you've been here. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.